Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see some of the methods before we design the factor of safety. So, statistical method for determining the factor of safety, that is, before determining factor of safety for a material, some of the points need to be considered. That we are going to discuss here. So, I'll write down, before deciding a particular value of factor of safety, some important points are to be considered. So, when we are determining the factor of safety, some of the points to be considered, and those are, first of all, reliability of properties of materials and changes in these properties during its service condition. So, the first point is, when determining the factor of safety, we should consider the reliability of properties, that is, how the properties of materials will remain and for how much time. Reliable means it is considered as a life, that is, for how much duration the properties of material will remain unchanged, and if it is changing during the service conditions, then what is the amount of factor of safety we have to consider. So the first point in the consideration of factor of safety is the reliability of the properties of materials. Next, it is extent of loss of life. So this is the most important point when we are considering or determining the factor of safety, that is, extent of loss of life. If we are designing any component and that component, is it harmful to the human beings or is it unharmful, that we have to decide. And even if we are designing, for example, we are designing trains or aircrafts, there the factor of safety which is considered is high, because the extent of loss of human life or chances of extent of loss of human life is more in case of such applications. So we have to choose a high factor of safety while designing the components in which human life is considered. Next, extent of loss of property. And the next point is, if there are chances that if we are designing any component that will result in loss of property, that is, a component while in its operation, it may, for example, explode, and because of that explosion there may be loss of property. So we have to select a high factor of safety in such conditions where the extent of loss of life or the extent of loss of property is considered. Next, extent of localized stress. That is, localized stress means stress concentration. So we have to see that if there is a material, stress concentration means stress will be concentrated only at one region or one part. So extent of localized stress means in the complete component, stress will be accumulated at a point or at some location, not the entire part. So that is called a stress concentration. So if we are using a material and in its operation, if the stress gets concentrated when it is loaded, then also we have to select high amount of factor of safety. Next, extent of initial stresses setup. So the extent of initial stresses setup, it means when the component was manufactured, in that manufacturing stage, if some stresses, residual stresses or internal stresses were stored in the material, then that stored stresses, when the object is used in some application, because of the stress present internally, there are chances of failure of that component. So we have to again select a high amount of factor of safety, which will reduce the value of stress on the material because of initial stresses setup, so we can avoid the failure of that material. And next, the last point, which is the reliability of applied load. It means when we are having a component, then in its working life, we are designing the component for some particular value of load. But if the value exceeds that load, then there are chances of failing of that material. So while selecting a proper value of load for a material, we have to check for its reliability. That is, whether the object is able to resist that much amount of load. And we should only load that material or object with the maximum load which we have used for the design, not some very high value that will ultimately lead into the failure of that material. So in this video, we have seen the points we have to consider while designing or deciding the factor of safety.